Test, test, test. Check, check, check. 1, 2. Test, test. Chest, chesticles. Doggies are looking at me. What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So today I wanted to do something a little bit differently. Tomorrow we will be back to our regularly scheduled programming. My hair looks terrible, man. Holy crap. But if you guys remember, I got a new camera a couple months back. I decided it was time to do a review on it because I've had it long enough and I already actually got rid of the camera. And this video is explaining why I actually upgraded to the camera I'm using right now, which is the Canon 70D. And it's actually for one reason and one reason only. So, the Canon 60D. It is the first Canon DSLR prosumer model that Canon came out with that had full high definition video on it. The reason why I originally went for it is because it was actually in my budget. The camera you can get for anywhere between 300 and 350 bucks, maybe 400 bucks with a lens. Used, of course, because it came out about 5 or 6 years ago. And I wanted something that was gonna be extremely versatile. I can use with a microphone, a bunch of lenses, all that fun stuff. There's one really, really big downfall for it. One feature that that camera does not have. You ready for it? This is it right here. Auto-focusing. Why is that important? Because you want everything to be in focus, of course. The problem with the Canon 60D is that it does not autofocus when you're shooting video, live video. And it's not to its fault, it's just something that didn't exist yet. The sensor does not have, so what happens is when the mirror drops down to reveal the sensor then takes place and records the video, much of like what is happening right now. But the sensor on the 60D does not have autofocusing capabilities. So you had a couple options. You can either just do it manually, which is what I did for the last 2 months, or you can press the shutter button every time you need to focus, which again is super annoying and really, really slow. By the way, I should mention this. This is strictly for vlogging. I'm not downing the camera for anything else. It takes amazing pictures. It really does shoot amazing video. The last 2 months of my vlogs have been on that camera. You're gonna do a lot better vlogging with something like this, a G-series Canon, something like this, the GoPro, even your phone. All of these have one feature that that camera does not, and it's auto-focusing. That's huge. That got in the way many times. It got in the way when I would try to find something really cool and quick to shoot, but I would have to turn the camera on and then look in the LCD and make sure that I'm in focus. By then, I probably missed the shot already. So it's just not practical to not have auto-focusing while you're vlogging. Now keep in mind, I'm only talking about vlogging. Vlogging is your everyday life. You're getting quick little shots in and you're doing your thing and you're done. That also meant that when you have to go there and focus, there's a lot more editing that you have to do post because you have to edit out all those little times that you're going in and you're freaking zooming and then focusing and then you're wasting time doing it. So it's not worth it. If you want to talk about why it's a good camera besides vlogging, I can do that all day long. If you're a videographer and you're shooting wedding, I don't even know about weddings to be honest with you, but if you're shooting movies, even if you're shooting weddings, anything like that, it's a great camera. It does amazing. It's got amazing video quality to it. It's super versatile. You can put any lens on the planet you want on it because again, it's a Canon. For example, I have two right behind the camera actually. So I've got a 50 millimeter, the Nifty 50. This is the newest one that just came out. The f-stop 1.8 makes it really fast for low light situations, unlike the lens I have right now that I'm using. But the great thing about this lens is that it's super wide. It's a 10 by 18, I was just staring at the freaking thing. 10 to 18 millimeter, f4.5 to 5.6, which is a little slow, so I had to actually bump up the ISO for this video. You could use these lenses, you could use that right there. This is, I can't wait to shoot my first BMX video with this lens actually. I'm super excited about it. That's why you want a digital SLR, but that's not why you want the 60D for vlogging. If you're looking for something that is more budget friendly, get, you know, a Canon G1X. You can get them for like $250. It does 1080. It's got a hot shoe. You can put a nice microphone on it, like the Rode mic that I have right now. Anyways, that's it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I'll be back tomorrow, hopefully, with new BMX videos and my daily life. Sorry, I was looking at my dog over here. But I will be back tomorrow with a regular video. I just wanted to throw that out there. I had it, the camera, for a couple months, and it just wasn't working out for me. So anyways, thank you guys so much for watching, and please subscribe. I do BMX videos and car videos, and every once in a while I'll do a review video of some camera equipment. And that's it. Again, thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you next time. Peace. Turn off. My AC kicked on, and you can probably hear it, so.